I don't see nothing wrong with somebody who dedicates their entire life to helping fix this perversion, to help fix this nonsense that's going on. Because, well, how can you live? Like, what life is there? If you spend your whole life trying to fix the perversion, trying to at least help, do your part. Okay, I know you're not going to take all of the matters into your hands and fix it all single-handedly, but you can help, though. You can help. I think that should be the biggest, that should be the main focus on all of our lives, to fix the problem. I mean, goddamn, how can you go into bondage, right? Into slavery. I mean, think about it. If you go into captivity, wouldn't your biggest focus in life be getting the hell out? Or shouldn't it be? Or if you're not helping others out, trying to help others out, doing what you can do to help your children get out, or your children's children, the descendants of our people, get out. Well, that's what I'm saying. If, how can you just get comfortable and just sit there and say, I'm comfortable here, this is what it is, this is just comfortable here? No, we're not just gonna up and just walk out. But it's a lack of knowledge. If we understand that it's a lack of knowledge while we're in here, that we're in a state of confusion, it's understanding. I don't understand how you can be a person who goes out up around people. Let's just say that you do have some knowledge, but then you're always leaving the house and you're always going up around folks, people, crowds of your own people too. And you realize that they're out of their mind. You can see it. Slurring their words. O'clock in the morning, already drunk. You feel me? Obviously high. Or just out of their mind. But then you ain't got nothing to say. You see it for what it is, and it's just like, all right, y'all, have a good one. And you're just going about your business to the next place that you want to go spend some money at, or go shopping at, or make an appearance at, so people can give you admiration because of how clean your clothes are, your watch. You feel me? That's what your day consists of, bouncing around from spot to spot, but you're not helping nobody. You are out around all of these people during this day and even at night, whatever, and you see what's wrong with us. It's not like you can't see it. You see it. And you didn't even utter a word to even try to offer some advice or some knowledge or some understanding to anybody. You know what I'm saying? Because you know that it's more than just physical shackles. You understand that these people are mentally mind fucked. They're mind warped. They're shackles on the mind too. You know what I mean? And these people lack understanding. And you know that you can give a little, but you rather not give none. That to me, I just don't understand that. I don't understand that. I say that if you want to go out and be around these people, you should try until they start to reject you. At least you tried. And then you realize that they are rejecting. That's okay. When your car pull up, you see people kind of start to scatter. All right, here he go. Here goes Mr. Hotep. Or here comes Mr. You know what I mean? Preacher man. Here comes Mr. Know-it-all. I've been there, so I know. I'm not just saying it. I know. I've seen people start to scramble when I come up. Here comes Mr. Know-it-all. I'm trying to help. I don't give a good guy. That didn't stop me from trying to help. Whoever is willing to listen and have the conversation, then it will be had. Whoever wants to walk off and call me a Mr. Know-it-all or say that I'm ruining their high or whatever the hell, okay. Well, you can leave, or you don't have to have the conversation. That's all I'm saying, man. All I'm saying, if you're going to come around, make it worthwhile, man. Try to help. Try to help. You know what I'm saying? It goes deeper than that. What do you want to live your life doing? Are there folks out there putting their lives on the line? I say that the Most High is pretty satisfied with Malcolm X and the way that he lived his life. And I would say that Malcolm X is pretty satisfied with the way that he lived his life. Nobody's going to be 100%, but I'm pretty sure that he's, you know what I'm saying? He would rather did what he did and died on it than sit around playing a goddamn Xbox, drinking beers, eating steak on his ass, catering to a woman's needs, paying bills, and just hanging out on his porch watching the fucking cars ride by and listening to music and die like that? Yeah, right. He'd rather die liberating his people. I already know that for a fact. Even with all the bullets that he took, he would take even more if it meant that he had to go back and just sit around on his ass and worry about his own situation. When really, that's the illusion of worrying about your situation. That's you giving up on life and not giving a fuck about yourself or nobody else. You know what I mean? You don't care. You're not studying, you're not reading, you're not trying to gain an understanding at all. You're not trying to teach yourself, let alone teach others. You're not even trying to teach or enlighten your own children. That is worse than a piece of shit to me. That has to be worse than a piece of shit. That has to be worse than a piece of shit. And these same people sit around, and since they never murdered nobody, and since they don't rob banks, and since they don't disturb the order of Babylon to the point where the police want to come and lock them up or something like that, they're not a criminal, then they'll get it in their head that I'm highly favored by God because I got a job, my bills are paid, I'm not backed up on car payments, I got a full tank of gas, I got a refrigerator full of food, my lights are on, my water bill is paid, I'm blessed, I'm highly favored by God. And then to die and really realize that you ain't been shit. You ain't been nothing but dung your whole entire life. Nothing but dung. A heartless piece of shit. You know what I'm saying? And it's not that you didn't know that people were out there fighting this truth struggle. It's not that you didn't know that people were out there being labeled as domestic terrorists just for speaking truth. It's not that you didn't know that. You know what I'm saying? It's not that you lived your whole life not knowing that the CIA was putting people or the FBI was putting people on their watch list just for caring about our people and trying to speak truth to their goddamn lies. You can't act like you didn't know that. You knew that. You know what I'm saying? You did know that. And you said, I don't want to deal with that. That kind of person is mentioned of in the Bible. Right? When our people are dealing with heavy oppression, there's going to be a brother who is going to have what it takes to help the situation. And he's going to say, I don't want to be involved in that. Don't get me involved in that. I got my own thing going on over here. Ain't that what it said? Come on, man. Look at our people. It's not just one brother or two brothers. Look at our people. It's all of these motherfuckers. It's every uncle I ever had. It's my own goddamn dad. It's my grandpa even. Come on now. It's every friend. It's every nigga that I ever called my friend. Every associate that I damn near ever had. They're all worrying about their own little dumb shit. My brothers included. You want to have a conversation that has any type of love in it? Real love. Not the illusion, that shit that they talk about. A conversation that has love in it and some substance in it? They don't want to have that. You're a weirdo. You know what I mean? Something's wrong with you. Our aunties, our mothers, our grandmothers included. No one cares. They're all just basking and bathing and shit. You know what I'm saying? And you, when you want to clear out the toxins, and you start to clear out the toxins, even in yourself, oh, you're starting, you changed. Oh, you changed. You know what I mean? Oh, you changed. You want to go to the bar, drinks on me? Nah, bro. Wow, you changed. Oh, I changed. Think about that. Now you no longer eat pork. Okay, you a Muslim? Why I gotta be a Muslim? Because I want to eat something that's toxic for me. Why do I have to be labeled as some certain type of thing, right? Because I don't want to eat some poison. You feel me? You ask that same person that says, oh, you a Muslim now? You ask that same person, is a pig filthy? Like, yeah. So a pig is filthy, it eats slop, it eats nasty, molded, corroded, rotten stuff. It'll eat a dead carcass that's been laying on the ground for a month. Will it not? Oh, it will. Then shut your ass up talking to me then. You know what I'm saying? That's the truth though, for real though. That's just the truth of the matter. Nobody wants to have those discussions. Nobody wants to make sense. Everybody wants to act retarded when they know better. And as long as you're not acting retarded while you know better, then you're the problem. Now here comes the persecution. Now here comes the persecution. Not only by the punk ass cops, because as soon as you know better and start to do better, now you become on a government watch list. Now the cops are riding by stalking you. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't even make sense. That's when you start to realize you're so-called targeted. You feel me? You realize you're targeted before you even applied that term to a person. Before you knew that you can even apply that term to a person, you start to realize that you're targeted. You know what I mean? And now nothing rubs you right. Nobody rubs you right. And you don't rub nobody right, even in your own family. You know what I'm saying, though? But I'm saying, how can you get comfortable living in the pit, in the flames, in the fire? How do you put your feet up, kick your legs up? You know what I'm saying? You got females out there claiming to be living their best life. But it's a song written by a dude. But we already know who it was for. If women and faggots are singing that they're living their best life, why us men, you would never hear us playing that in our car. You would never hear us singing those lyrics, right? Because it doesn't apply to us. We're not living our best fucking life. We're getting shot down on camera. We're getting our manhood snatched out from between our fucking legs. We're getting called toxic masculinity just for being what we were born to be. They don't cause toxic masculinity for running around here whooping people's ass and shooting people down. They cause toxic masculinity for speaking truth and trying to stand on what's real. They call you toxic masculinity just for going into the gym and lifting weights and grunting and making noises. Because you're picking up something that's heavy. You know what I'm saying? It's supposed to be quiet as a goddamn library. Why? Because it suits fags and women. Because they're not lifting heavy shit. Women are not they're making the environment suitable for them and not for us. When the gym used to be ours. You know what I'm saying? And they're giving it to women. When rap music used to be ours, and they're giving it to women. When even the church used to be ours, and now they're giving it to women and sodomites. Everything I just named, they're giving to women and sodomites. Come on, man. Who's running the rap game right now? Lil fucking Nas. You know what I'm saying? What sitcom got the most rewards? A lot of people ain't paying attention to that. RuPaul's Drag Race. Yep. RuPaul's Drag Race. Nominated every year. Everybody love Martin Lawrence. Martin, how many times did they get nominated? Never. I seen it. I watched that show. I was supposed to make a video about it, but I didn't, because that's some more shit I said. I still got the evidence. Anyway. You know, how do I put you in a pit? You and your people and your family and everyone in a pit, right? And then I light the pit on fire. And then I give y'all activities to do up amongst the fire. When you go out to eat, fire. You know what I'm saying? Even when you're in your house, the fire's lit. Night out on the town, the fire is lit. How do you get comfortable up around that fire? Somebody's sitting here telling you the fire's right here. You can't call them a liar, but you just don't want nothing to do with that. Look at the ingredients in your food. The fire is in there. I can prove it beyond shadow of a doubt. I don't want to talk about that. You're taking away my comfort. See that? I can show you how your whole relationship and the whole dynamics of your house is backwards. It's ran invertedly. It's backwards. I can show you and prove to you beyond shadow of a doubt. I can even use the scriptures to back up what I'm saying. You care to listen?
No.
You want to hear about that? I can show you what they're doing to that water. But they're like drug addicts. They're going to get high until... They're going to continue on this high. They're going to get high and get high and get high until the wheels fall off. They're going to get high until they can no longer get high no more. They're going to get high until the wheels fall off. And that's what they do. That's what that old dude over there did. Little dummy. Yo, I can't drink alcohol no more. They said that if I keep drinking alcohol, I could lose my legs. I'm like, all right. He said, yeah, so I got to drink this, Gatorade. I'm like, I don't know who told you to drink Gatorade, but whatever. I ain't even saying nothing. You know what I mean? The doctors told him to drink Gatorade. I'm like, I ain't going to argue with this dude. I'm not going to argue with this dude. He's already out of his mind. All right, drink your Gatorade. I guess that is better than your alcohol. Whatever, man. You should be drinking water. Anyway. So then I see the dummy. Soon as the threat, the immediate threat went away, he's over there drinking again. I'm watching him with my own two eyes. Oh, he's back drinking again. Now, after that, every time I see him with a beer in his hand, I zoomed in and I automatically went into thought, like, beer in his hand, beer in his hand, beer in his hand. You know what I mean? Beer in his hand. And now he's running around here with one leg. Now he's running around here with one leg. And the alcoholics that would show up to his house every damn day or every other day are still showing up. And he's probably still drinking. Now, you mean to tell me that nobody is smart enough to tell this man to keep new company? I remember when that old lady over there started going senile and started losing her damn mind. Her family told me to keep him. Here, take my number. We don't want him hanging with her anymore. He is an alcoholic. She is not allowed to drink anymore. She has to keep new company, they said. Give us a call if you see any activity, even her family from Birmingham. If you see them down here at her house, please give us a call. They're trying to save the old lady's life. I'm like, all right, but I knew I wasn't getting, I'm not. You feel me? That lady went all of these years drinking on that poison. I knew I wasn't going to snitch. Yeah, they're over here. I wasn't going to do that. Anyway. Don't worry about me, I'm just thinking.